Hello dear friends, our today's topic is General Structures of H1 Antagonist. The H1 antagonists are also called as sedating drugs. That means this H1 antagonist causes sedation, or which is also called as drowsiness. So let's look at their general structures. Now, the general structure possessed by all H1 antagonists include such kind of feature. Here we have a nitrogen attached with the alkyl groups, a spacer which is attached with an atom X, which in turn is attached with the aromatic rings. So let's look, when the X means this atom is nitrogen, the class or the general category so obtained is called as ethylene diamine. When this X is an oxygen attached with the carbon, we will call such kind of category as ethanol amine ethers. When this X is simply a carbon, we will call this category as alkyl amines. So this general feature is present in these three category of H1 antagonist. So ethylene diamines, ethanol amine ethers and alkyl amines share this common structural feature. Here the nitrogen is a must with the alkyl substituents. A spacer is must between this nitrogen and other hetero atom. That other hetero atom or other atom may be attached with two aromatic rings. In most of the cases, the aromatic ring is generally a phenyl ring or a thiophene ring or a pyridine ring attached with its second position. And in most of the cases, the spacer, that is the distance between the nitrogen and the other atom, is CH2, that is methylene, for N times. N may be any number. For example, in most of the cases, N is equal to either 2 or 3. Usually, it is found to be 2. That means the spacer in most of the cases is a 2-carbon chain. So, if we put 2 here, it will become CH2CH2. That means it will become ethylene. So let's look at the first category, that is ethylene diamines. This is the general structure of ethylene diamines. Here you can compare the general structure with this structure. So nitrogen is here with two methyl groups. Here is a 2-carbon spacer between this nitrogen. And in case of ethylene diamine, the other atom or the X is a nitrogen. And this X, or in this case nitrogen, is attached with two aromatic groups. First is this one and another one. One is this one, which can be represented by a 6-member ring, which may be substituted with some other atoms than that of carbon. So let's look at some example. The first example is tripalinamine. Dear students, please look at this name very carefully, because if you know this name, it is very easy to understand the substituent groups present over here. For example, in case of tripalinamine, these three substituent groups are present. So this T, if you look here, This T stands for toluene-like structure. For example, when this CH2 is attached with this AR, that is phenyl ring, it will become a toluene type of structure. So from toluene we will take T. So T here stands for a phenyl ring attached with a carbon. Now look here, RIP. So instead of RIP, we will consider it as PIR. I repeat once again, we consider it PIR. That PIR stands for pyridine. So here is presence of this pyridine ring. Here, this X is a nitrogen. So if we put nitrogen over here, it will become a pyridine ring which will attach with it position number 2. The next example is tonsillamine. Now if we look at the substituents present in tonsillamine, we will find that this TH stands for thiophene. So here the aromatic ring present is thiophene. This zillamine stands for pyrimidine ring. In the case of tonsillamine, the X and Y both are nitrogens. So the basic difference between triplenamine and the tonsillamine is, in case of triplenamine we will have a benzyl group, in case of tonsillamine we will have a thiophene attached with a carbon. In case of triplenamine, this ring is pyridine, and in case of tonsillamine, this ring is pyrimidine. Let's look at the next category, that is ethanol amine ether. Dear students, please look at the structure very carefully once again. Again, we have this common feature. We have a nitrogen attached with two methyl groups. We have a two carbon spacer. And here the X is an oxygen. This oxygen is attached with a carbon, which in turn is attached with three substituents, out of which these two are the aromatic rings. So very quickly, we will look at the examples. If we look at the examples carefully, we will get hint of the structure. For example, in case of diphenhydramine, we have the presence of two phenyl rings here. So ultimately this R1 will be H, this R2 will be H, and this X will also become a CH. So here is a phenyl and here is also a phenyl. So this such compound is called as diphenhydramine. Now look at second example, which is bromodiphenhydramine. So once again, this diphen stands for presence of the two phenyl rings, and a bromo is present on one of the phenyl ring at the para position. So in this case, the R1 is a bromine, R2 is a hydrogen, and X is once again a carbon. The next example is chlorodiphenhydramine. Once again, we have a diphen, that means two phenyl rings are attached. We have a chloro, that means the R1 is a chlorine. The R2 is once again H. The last example is doxylamine. Now, dear students, in case of doxylamine, here we have a hydrogen. So we have a phenyl ring over here. In case of R2 substituent, it is a methyl group. And now here in this case, we have a nitrogen. That means we have a pyridine ring over here. So the difference between all the four compound is that the first three consist of a diphenyl ring, while the doxylamine consists of one phenyl and one pyridine ring. The next category is alkyl amines. This name will give us the hint. Alkyl, that means the substituent is a carbon over here. So it will form a alkyl group attached with a nitrogen. So it will become alkyl amine. So once again we have a nitrogen attached with 2-methyl, we have a 2-carbon spacer, and here we have X which is equal to a carbon. So in this way it will become 3 carbons attached with a nitrogen. So commonly they are also referred as propanamines, and in this case this carbon is attached with 2 aromatic substituent groups, out of which one is a phenyl substituted at para position and the other one is a pyridine ring attached with its position number 2. We have very simple examples from this category. The first example is phenyramine. In case of phenyramine, this R is simply a hydrogen. Second example is chlorpheniramine, where this R substituent is a chlorine. We have the next example, bromphenyramine, where this R is a bromine. So these 3 are very simple examples of this category. The next category of H1 antagonist is the piperazines. Now, dear students, this piperazine indicate the presence of this heterocycle, which is called as piperazine. This piperazine consists of 2 nitrogens at 1 and 4 position to each other. Both the nitrogens are substituted. This nitrogen is substituted by a diphenyl methyl group, and this nitrogen is substituted by an alkyl group. So this piperazine class of H1 antagonist is referred as the combination of ethanol amine ethers and ethylene diamine. If we look at the structure of piperazine, we find that both these nitrogens are separated by a 2-carbon space. So this feature is present in ethylene diamines, while this kind of feature is present in ethanol amine ethers. So piperazine class of H1 antagonist is referred as combination of both the categories. From here we have the example chlorcyclazine. In this case, the R1 is simply a chlorine. You can guess its presence by this word, chlore. The R2 substituent is a methyl group. The next example is meclizine. Dear students, once again we have a Cl over here. That means the R1 is a chlorine. The R2 is once again a methyl, but a substituted one. A methyl substituted by a phenyl ring, which in turn is substituted by a methyl at the position number 3. The next example is buclizine. Now if we look at the name, once again a Cl is here, that means R1 should be a Cl, and the R2 will be once again a methyl, that is CH2, attached with a phenyl ring. But in the case of buclizine, this Bu stands for presence of this tertiary butyl group. Dear students, we can guess the difference between meclizine and buclizine. In case of meclizine, it is methyl phenyl, and in case of buclizine, it is tertiary butyl phenyl substituent group. The last class is the tricyclic compounds. Here the general structure found is of phenothiazine, and from this category we have two examples in our syllabus. The first example is promethazine and the next example is trimeprazine. So both promethazine and trimeprazine consist of phenothiazine, which is substituted by a carbon chain on this nitrogen. For example, in case of promethazine, the carbon chain is of 2 carbon long attached with a nitrogen and having a methyl branch over here. In case of trimeprazine, the carbon chain attached on to this nitrogen is a 3 carbon long, which have a methyl substituent at the second position. So with this, we find the difference between promethazine and trimeprazine. So whenever this word is here, thazine, that means the heterocyclic nucleus present is phenothiazine. So dear student, that is all about the general structure possessed by the H1 antagonist. We will look into the detail of individual drugs belongs to the antihistaminics into our next video and lecture. Thanks for watching. Please like and share. Thank you.